In this video, we will show you how to find and diagnose a flat roof leak. There are two types of flat roofs, the ones that leak and the ones that are going to leak. Additionally, many flat roof leaks are misdiagnosed and many times unnecessary expensive repairs are performed. The owner of this flat roof has had flat roof leaks since the day the building was purchased, which was roughly 10 years ago. The building owner employed many roofing contractors to make roof repairs, which included the installation of new roof membranes, the installation of new flashing, and the installation of new top reflective sealant coatings. After all these repairs, the roof membrane still leaked. The building owner and his secretary would control roof leaks with buckets. The last roofer decided to get an opinion from a building scientist, Marko Vovk, that would be I, to help diagnose the roof leaks. The roofer cut the roof membrane and found trapped water. Water was running between the membranes and leaking at two different room locations below. While on the roof, I asked the maintenance man to bring me a 5-gallon bucket full of water. I threw several cups of water to the upper elevation brick wall. The water beat it off. I asked the maintenance man who sealed the brick. He said that 10 years ago, when they bought the building, the previous owner disclosed that the window at this location leaked and it was repaired. He wasn't sure about the brick ceiling. He stated that since this repair, the window has not leaked. While it was quite obvious that somebody 10 years ago knew it was the brick that was leaking and not the window. This is why they sealed the brick with what appeared to be a water-resistant coating. While on the roof, I walked over to the location where one of the roof leaks was occurring. A brick higher elevation roof wall also existed at this location. I threw several cups of water onto this brick. This time, the water was absorbed or sucked into the brick. Brick and mortar joints are naturally absorbent. This is why you need weep holes in brick. This brick upper wall did not have weep holes. The building roof that had these two roof leaks was an addition that was built over 20 years ago. The brick was getting saturated during long duration rains. This wall also faced a southern and western exposure, which is more susceptible to weather and rain. The water was getting sucked into the brick and mortar joints and running down the back side of the brick in the 3/4-inch capillary space. The newer addition building had roof joists that rested on pocket ledges that were cut into the brick 20 years ago. Instead of water running down into the lower levels, it escaped into these cut pockets. This was going to be an easy fix. Simply by sealing the exterior brick would fix this leak. I did warn the owner that when you seal brick, it is no longer able to breathe and a potential of brick spalling may occur. I told the owner to control indoor humidity by running a dehumidifier during cold climates. The reason for this is that if you have high indoor humidity, it will travel to the exterior through a vehicle called vapor diffusion. If the brick is sealed on the exterior, it will act like a vapor barrier. During the winter, it is cold, it freezes, and the brick spalling may occur. So controlling indoor humidity when you have sealed brick is very important. The second diagnostic was also simple. Directly above the second leak was a 12-year-old HVAC unit. We cut into the roofing membrane at this location and encountered moisture. I asked the maintenance man to bring me a second 5-gallon bucket of water. This time, I dumped it into the HVAC unit fan area. It wasn't long before the water started dripping into the room below. In the room below, you could see the roof fasteners rusting and dripping water. The secretary said the roof would leak for several days after rainstorms. This leak existed for 12 years due to the HVAC insulation contractor not being a roofer. The rooftop unit had a roof duct penetration that was poorly sealed. The HVAC installing contractor created this leak 12 years ago. This was also an easy repair. The HVAC unit needed to be lifted and the roof membrane needed to be replaced. Sometimes when looking for leaks, you need to apply some building science knowledge, not just roofing knowledge. Sometimes roof leaks are not roof membrane related, as they were in this case. Please subscribe and watch my other videos.